Okay, so today we're going to talk about polynomial functions. So a polynomial, let me give you some examples. So if we look at y equal 3x plus 2, that's a polynomial. If we look at y is equal to x squared, that's a polynomial. Or we could look at y equal x squared minus 3x minus 2, that's a polynomial. We can look at y is equal to 14x cubed plus the square root of 2 times x squared plus 5x plus pi, that's a polynomial. And what makes all these things polynomials is our coefficients could be arbitrary real numbers. Our variables x appear in powers of 0, 1, 2, 3, 4, and higher powers. In general, a polynomial function of degree n is a function of the form f of x is equal to a sub n x to the n plus a sub n minus 1 x to the n minus 1 plus and so forth plus a2 x squared plus a1 x plus a0. It's a big expression and it looks pretty scary, but the point is that we don't know what the degree of the polynomial is. If you think about the polynomial as being analogous to a big number, we don't know whether this is trillions, billions, gazillions, or whatever, so we write it as the nth power. And we want our coefficient of the highest degree term to be non-zero. Now, some of these other coefficients can be zero. For example, you can have a polynomial like x cubed minus 1, and so that's x cubed plus 0x squared plus 0x minus 1. That's an example of a polynomial. So polynomials are important because polynomials are analogous to the natural numbers in a very strict sense. So now we have two families of polynomials, those that have even degree. And those that have odd degree. And I'm going to continue to write examples now. If I write the function y is equal to 14, well, 14 is an even number, but the degree is even because that's really 14 times x to the 0. Just to mix it up a little bit, we could write y is equal to 17x to the 0, or y is equal to 7. That's an even degree polynomial. If we write y is equal to x squared plus 2x minus 4, that's an even degree polynomial. And the point is that the degree of the highest degree term is even. So it might have odd degree terms. We could have y is equal to x to the 4th minus 18x cubed plus 17x squared minus x plus 2, that's an even degree polynomial. And for odd degree polynomials, well, we have our linear functions are odd degree polynomials. In general, y is equal to mx plus b is an odd degree polynomial. Y is equal to x cubed is an odd degree polynomial. Y is equal to x to the 5th minus 14 x to the 4th plus 8x minus 7 is an odd degree polynomial. So again, the degree of the highest degree term is odd. And the difference between even degree and odd degree polynomials is one that affects the long-term behavior of the polynomial. So if we have even degree polynomials, odd degree polynomials, well, for the degree zero polynomials, the long-term behavior is the functions are just going to be constants, so that's nothing there. But in general, the even degree polynomials are either going to be both up, both sides of the polynomial are up. We don't know what goes on in the middle, or both sides go down. And for the odd degree polynomials, well, for example, if we had the straight line, that would be an odd degree polynomial. You can have the function on average is always increasing or always decreasing, but that's an average behavior. And in the next video, we're going to discuss the short-term behavior of the polynomial, how we can determine that.